Alright, Elite Code 3, and today we're going to do a video showcasing some Super Bowl weekend sales. A lot of heavy hitters went this weekend. Many in auction format, so we'll start off with a few raw cards. I'll post a link to the store in the description, and then I'll do a little flyby with the name of the channel, or the name of my eBay store is Cardboard Futures, and my actual eBay username is KCFutures9. So if you want to shop in the store, there's always new items coming up. PSA orders coming back. A couple came back this month already. So let's take a look. All right, so this is raw. And this one has an issue. And I put it in the description. There's like a warping issue on the surface. So I honestly, I don't know how PSA would grade this one. I would say maybe a 7. But I mean, the card looks beautiful like this, but when you take it out and you tilt it, it's got some type of warping issue. So I mean, this one sold incredibly high for a Rob Bowman. So that one might get returned, and I mean, I don't know how else to sell it. I guess if it does get returned, I'll just take more pictures and kind of hold the card and show the warping more. Okay, this went for a lot more than I thought too. Came in, I want to say I bought it last month for about $1,600. And it looked like a good candidate. I decided not to send it in. I thought it looked like an 8. Not that an 8's bad, but I don't send in every single card that I get in. So, nice copy of Peyton, the Future Watch to 2000. Of course, it's on the back there, numbered, factory stamped there, 2000. Pacific. Actually, a pretty neat card, an incredibly sensitive set too. It's often chipped here on this green, and on the back's chipped too. So. Tens are impossible to come by. There are some nines out there, and those are probably getting close to what, $700 now. Here's a Herbert red, white, and blue. So a little ultra modern. I think it's the only ultra modern card in this. This was interesting. This went for a little more than I thought. You know, so sometimes when I run auctions, I don't do the market research because it's an auction. So Durant Finest probably would get a PSA 9 if you sent it in. Rogers Topps Chrome. It's got some light surface scratching. It's off center, so it's like a perfect 8. Enlisted as near mint. This actually sold. The auction ended on January 17th, and it went for over $600. So I think the buyer felt like he overpaid because that was kind of the market peak of this card raw. So he never ended up paying, and then I had to relist it towards the end of January. So it just sold again. Went for much less. That's the way it goes. Vic EX Auto. This is just a neat card. Solid hobby for Vic too. That's what I've noticed. I mean, his hobby hasn't exploded like a lot of players, but his hobby is steadily, slowly increasing. It's like a slow burn. We'll start off with this. There is a nice mix of SGC and PSA. I think there's a couple of Beckett cards in here, but here's our first graded card. SGC 10 Fitzgerald flagship. I believe this was right at 300, so very solid sell for that Fitzy. Okay, this Mantle. Had it in the collection. I wanted to get one in the lighthouse holder, and I wanted to try to get a 7 with better eye appeal. The problem with this for me personally is that top right corner dingy, and I know it's a 6, so I mean that's acceptable for a 6. All cards look different. Not all cards look the same. You know, you could have a 6 that looks a lot nicer than this, and it probably should sell for more. So Mantle 64 tops in a 6. Gonna look to upgrade. Try to get a 7. 1990 Bowman, a little water into wine action. This was a pack pulled pup. Very respectable sale. Peyton Manning Ultra in a 10. This was a CBF item. I mean, a lot of the cards that I have listed in CBF format, you know, the price is jacked up. They're pretty good, and a lot of times it's getting bought the way the market is. So Ultra, that's an outstanding image though. Here's a Breeze SPX. This is sweet. This is the blue version of the 250. There's also the gold with a different image and a gold, more like a gold background. But PSA 9 on this one. This was a monster. This was actually submitted by myself, and it came back in the spring. I kind of sad to see it go. I don't get to attach to the 10s, but because as a collector, I typically collect the 9s and sell the 10s. I've got a nice PSA 9 that I bought for like $60 that I have at home. So this one went for well over that. And yeah, so 83 tops Gwynn and an SGC 10. Pretty sick though, that card. I think PSA 10s are around 3,000 now on that card. Here's a Game Gear Breeze, not a, like the most highly sought after Breeze rookie. And in the SGC holder, I don't think it looks that good in this holder, but it's just an opinion, I guess. Brady Emerald, this one was, I think I actually sent this in a couple years ago. Probably bought it raw for $300 or $400. Maybe less, actually. So Brady Emerald at an 8. That's another condition sensitive set. Here's a Pujols 9 Bowman. This is actually a decent copy. That bottom right corner is, you know, it's not the nicest 9 I've seen. The centering's also a little shaky. I think on a different day, this could easily be an 8. This was in the PC. I had it forever. I mean, these were always like $40-$50 for the longest time. You know, I like go through my collection, and when cards get hot and I just have them sitting there, and I like look at them closely, and I looked at this one closely, it looked like a 9, so I was like, I don't need it, it's overgraded. Maguire in the old label. Here's a PSA 9 of the 401, the USA rookie. The market on this got extremely hot around June, July. I think these were over 300. It's dipped back, but they're still higher than they were before the documentary in June. Crazy price on this. Fleer 1992. I've broke a ton of boxes that this was from a box too. And you know, when I sent it in, I thought it was a 9. See that top to bottom. Most of the time, the primary issue with 92 Fleer basketball is the centering. It's tough cardstock. You don't get many dings at all straight from the pack. So Shaq 92 Fleer. This was this actually just came back. PSA 9 Clemens rookie, 85 tops. Here's a Brady Elite. You've got the 2000 Donruss Elite, about a 2000. You know, it's definitely a good time to list some Brady stuff. So, listed the Elite. This Wave of the Future just came back, actually. Let's see, this was a pre-grade 8, so I thought I would get an 8, and it came back a 9, so I went ahead and just sold it. It was like $1,700 for the Wave of the Future, so. Tatis SGC 10. This was $200. I'm gonna guess PSA 10s are around 300. I haven't looked at the market research, so could be off on that. This Young I actually bought raw for like $15 and just sent it in. It looked pretty good. I thought it would get an 8. Got an 8.5, and it was in the store for months, but somebody had to buy it now on it. So a nice Young 85 tops rookie. This card looks really cool in the SGC holder. Older cards, older basic tops cards look amazing in SGC, and in my opinion, newer stuff doesn't. Mahomes, that's the EC3 pre-grade 8.5. It came back at 10, so I mean, if it's gonna sell for $3,000 on an optic base card, I mean, I'm not gonna hold it. So take that, take those funds and look for some cool vintage cards. All right, so Calvin got into the Hall of Fame first ballot. Some people will argue that. I agree with it, but dominant player. So the Ultimate Collection, this was a, you would refer to it as a fake gem, but, and this was graded 6,900,000. So I actually got this graded back, I want to say around maybe 2011. I used to send to Becca a lot. So Ultimate Collection, Mookie Betts. This is just crazy what this card sells for. These were always like 10 bucks raw when I used to buy them. It is, not like a gimme set. I would guess the pop's about 60, 70%. It's not like the 90 to 95% pop cards, but to me, it's just for $500, $600. The card's overrated. Here's a cool pasta. That's the Future Watch Auto SGC 10. So some hockey sneaking in. So I guess we covered all four sports with that card. We got flagship Moss in a 10, the 98 tops. Crazy what these are selling for now. Let's do flagship Peyton. This is a BGS 95. So at this point, this I would guess I think the market on a Beckett 95 true even to a PSA 10 is probably like 60% of the value. That's just a rough estimation. Here's the I mean this card this was $40 all day for years and years. So to see this card at like $800 to me is nuts. But I guess the demand's that high for a card like this. I don't know. Just some of these cards I'm selling. It's not that I don't like them. It's just the market seems so high on them that I can afford to put a few in auction and see what happens. Plus it's kind of fun. And Philip Rivers, that's the Fleer Tradition base rookie. In the 10. Little shocked by how this one went. So that's it, guys. A nice round of stuff. So today's Monday. The stuff will all go out today. So if you order for me, you'll probably get your order Wednesday to Thursday. Take care. I'm out. Later. Bye.